measure shall we take while working with asbestos? It must be notified to the enforcement agency, work area shall be sealed, use appropriate PPE and RPE, negative pressure ventilation system with efficient filters. Asbestos waste control, securely double bagged, labeled, disposed as hazardous waste, dust levels monitored inside and outside sealed work area, worker exposure must not exceed control limit, health surveillance provided. Outline the steps to take while doing health risk assessment from chemicals. We shall take the following steps while doing the risk assessment for chemicals. The hazardous nature of the substance present, is it toxic, corrosive, carcinogenic, or any other health hazard? The potential ill health effects, will the substance cause minor ill health or very serious disease, and will these result from short-term or long-term exposure? The physical forms that the substance takes in the workplace, is it a solid, liquid, vapor, dust, fume? The routes of entry the substance can take in order to cause harm, is it harmful by inhalation, ingestion, skin absorption? The quantity of the hazardous substance present in the workplace, including the total quantities stored and the quantities in use or created at any one time. The concentration of the substance if stored or used neat or diluted, and the concentration in the air if airborne. The number of people potentially exposed and any vulnerable groups or individuals such as pregnant women or the infirm. The frequency of exposure, will people be exposed once a week, once a day, or continuously? The duration of exposure, will exposure be very brief, last for several hours, or last all day? The control measures that are already in place, such as ventilation systems and PPE.
What is dust monitor? How we can monitor is the dust exposure for the workers. Dust monitor is filter-based equipment that operates on air intake principle. It operates with motor-operated fan that takes the air sample by sucking the air from ambient environment. Air passes through an integrated filter and dust remain on the filter.
The dust filter is pre-weighed and dust monitor is worn by worker while working. Pumped air will suck the air from the atmosphere and at the end of the day filter is weighed again. The difference in weight of the filter will give average exposure value of dust over a day. Ammonia has been released into the atmosphere of a workplace. Outline typical health effects resulting from the exposure to ammonia. Ammonia is harmful if inhaled, corrosive and irritant, corrosive and toxic to marine life. The typical health effect to the worker exposed to ammonia in the air may be outlined as below. Inhalation, exposure to high concentrations of ammonia in the air causes immediate burning of the nose, throat, and respiratory tract. This can cause bronchiola and alveolar edema, an airway destruction resulting in respiratory distress or failure. Inhalation of lower concentrations can cause coughing, and nose and throat irritation. Exposure to the high concentration as more than 300 ppm may be fatal, as it is immediately dangerous to life and health. High concentration of NH3 may lead to oxygen deficient condition and workers may be suffocated. Skin or eye contact. Ammonia is reactive with the moisture and exposure to low concentrations of ammonia in air may produce rapid skin or eye irritation due to reaction with moisture. Higher concentrations of ammonia may cause severe injury and burns. Give the meaning of the acute health effect. Acute health effects are quickly seen, usually after exposures to fairly high levels or concentrations of hazardous substances. For example, exposure to carbon monoxide, CO 1200 ppm. A worker exposed to this high amount of CO can have the acute effect of losing consciousness and die. Identify suitable air monitoring methods for the ammonia. Air monitoring of ammonia. Ammonia fixed gas detectors operated by pump suction, Portable gas detectors are used to measure the concentration in working area by pump suction as well as diffusing method. Personal gas detectors used to detect the personal exposure. Explain what our good practice organization shall adopt while there are chemicals on the workplace. The following principles of good practice exist with regard to controlling exposure to substances. Minimization of emission, release, and spread of hazardous substances through design and operation of processes and task activities. Wherever possible, processes should be modified to remove the hazardous substances altogether, to substitute them for a less hazardous alternative, or, if that is not possible, design a work process that controls the substance at source. This can be achieved in many ways, for example, by totally enclosing the substance so that it can't contact a person, or by providing engineering controls such as extraction. Effectiveness and reliability of control options that minimize the escape and spread of hazardous substances. Elimination is clearly the most reliable control option, as, once eliminated, the chemical is no longer an issue. However, this is not always possible and therefore other controls must be selected carefully. Controls that rely on the worker to implement them are less likely to be successful. For example, portable extraction used when welding may be forgotten or used incorrectly. Exposure control to be proportional to health risk. Greater resources should be used to combat the greatest hazards, therefore, the level of control would usually be highest for the most hazardous substances. Personal protective equipment. PPE should be used in combination with other control measures if adequate control can't be achieved otherwise. Specifically, respiratory protective equipment may be required if airborne concentrations are still considered too high, for example exceeding an OEL. Other PPE, gloves, overalls, and eye protection may be useful control measures if required. Personal hygiene and protection regimes. Good personal hygiene can prevent, for example, from accidental ingestion of materials through eating with contaminated hands. Vaccinations may be available against some infectious materials, but this is very much a last line of defense, and contact with substances must be avoided. Health and medical surveillance. Health checks may be required to monitor the potential development of an ill health condition. Explain that how the passive sampler monitors working and measuring the chemical exposures. These use absorbent chemicals to sample contaminants without using a pump to draw air through the collector. They give a measure of concentration over a period of time and can be used for gases and vapors. The sampler is designed to allow gas or vapor to diffuse to an absorbent surface. At the end of the sampling period, the sampler is sent for laboratory analysis. The requirement for analysis does make this a more complex and expensive and slower process, requiring training in its use. However, the results can be very accurate and can be used to calculate time-weighted measurement results. Identify when selecting the RPE what shall be considered. Following are the factors to be considered when selecting an RPE. Concentration of the contaminant and its hazards. Physical form of the substance. Level of protection offered by the RPE. Presence or absence of oxygen. Duration of time that it must be worn. Compatibility with other items of PPE. Shape of the user's face. Facial hair. Physical requirements of the job. Physical fitness of the wearer.